talking to you at Bonfire, you still ain't talking to me, and you at my house? Oh, you finna get dragged. Jordan was already bump in the door. Yes. Before the girl even walked in the door, Jordan was ain't even asked no questions. Bump! I was like, oh shit. What's up, everybody? I'm Princess Leia.
This your boy, D-Flo.
And welcome back to the Luv Xperience. So today, we have our girl, Jordan. If y'all don't remember, she is from our show, TRI LUV. And Jordan is one of our really close friends, so we wanted to bring her on here just to discuss some things that happened on the show, how she feels, where she's at right now, everything. And you know, we better get lit. Y'all know, before we get into any episode, y'all know what we do. Y'all see three cups up here, so y'all know my girl, she, look, this was her, what they call that when they have a little thing, what is that called?
Ritual.
Not a ritual, when they have a little, y'all help me out. Y'all know what I'm talking about when you send your artist or your client and then when they get booked for something and they have
celebration.
Like say for instance, if I'm getting booked for something and I'm in my hotel and I gotta have Skittles.
Oh, you talking about your rider?
Yeah, your rider. Yeah, this is her rider, y'all. She had to have the Casasuas. So this was her because you know we had the De Leon.
If you're in the music industry, you'll understand what that means.
Only if you're in the music industry, you would know what that is, or the acting industry, I guess.
Yeah.
So we know, yeah, I just couldn't figure out the word. You know, it's been a minute, so I couldn't figure out the word.
All right, Jordan, come on out.
Ooh, bring it out, Ray. Look at it. Just love it.
What's up?
Hey, guys, how are you?
Good.
Good.
Thank you
for having me. For sure, we appreciate you coming on the show.
No problem.
It's natural looking beautiful and stuff.
Just a little.
He's so silly. I love it. All right, you guys. So y'all know what we do on here. Every time before any episode, we always take a shot.
Exactly.
That's our little ritual. She already know the ritual because she comes to the house and be with the shit.
Getting it overly.
Just chilling.
Right. Right. So we on the vibes today. So let's go ahead and do it.
All right. Here you go.
I'm gonna let y'all pull y'all on.
It's good to see y'all again.
Yes,
yeah, for real. It's been a minute. Dang, she pulled a big old
this is a shot.
Shot.
That's D-Flo cup now.
That's a double shot.
This is a shot.
Oh, she's trying to get glass. Lit, y'all.
That's sweet.
Okay. It's a shot glass.
Wait, you can pull your. What's that? You can pull your own shot.
Oh my God.
It's a shot glass. What the hell? But no.
I mean, how much?
No, we
don't
want to
pour you too much.
Own.
You know, you pull your own. You want to pour full? Go ahead.
Yeah. See? She ain't. Okay, well, yeah.
I ain't overdoing it.
Girl, I think I might
have
did a little too.
All right, I'm gonna get lit with y'all. So what are we taking a shot to? Like, I want to take a shot to a great season one of TRI LUV.
That was a good
that
season.
That was a good season. Yes. I can't even lie. Like amazing people still season. Texting me and asking me about it. So I know we really did something.
We really did a thing.
We reached a whole new community.
We did, for sure.
We definitely reached.
We got good views. Ooh, everything was great. Oof. Damn.
Ooh, let's get into this shit.
Yeah, that was a big shot. I ain't gonna lie. But first of all, I just want to ask you.
I like it, but
how do you feel about, like, when you're watching the show? Was it like, how do you feel when you watch? Was it the first time you ever did something like that?
Well, yeah, because I came from like the video girl world and like the skit, Instagram skits. So, yeah, so this is my first time really being on like a whole season project type of thing, and it was. It was different, but I kind of knew what to expect because I talked to Leia about it or whatever. So she knew I kind of knew what I was in for, if that makes sense.
Right. But as you were watching it, how did you feel? Like, it was pretty lit.
Yeah, it was a lot going on.
So my main part that I wasn't really fucking with is how I looked like a bully. I told Leia this. Because I'm like, come on, Yon's is a grown ass woman. Come on now. Like, you know, clap back mamas.
It's a lot of things. I think it's kind of like, you know, a little background of what happens
in
production. A lot of times you don't see what actually goes on the background, you know. And I think that's kind of where, you know, it's just a lot of things got left out where they might be like, oh, she's a bully, but really.
I wanted to clear that air. I'm not no bully. I might be messy, but I ain't no bully.
It's a difference, ain't it?
It's a big difference.
I mean, you just got a lot of energy. You came with a lot of energy.
And you knew what you was on. Like,
yeah,
You knew what you stood for, and that's what really mattered. And I respect you for that. Now, as far as Yon, I can't really speak on how.
She can speak for herself.
Yeah.
And we're going to bring her on the show, too, eventually when we get the opportunity to.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hopefully we'll be able to talk again so we could clear the air with each other. But we cool.
Yeah. Everything ended up really cool with y'all because, you know, you recorded the show.
Yeah.
It was lit.
Like, that was amazing to be able to learn how to work a camera.
And so another thing I want to touch on, what y'all didn't see, y'all, after we got done off stage performing, Jordan was in the dressing room where we were, like in the rehearsal room. This girl was in there boohoo crying, like, oh my god, that shit was so.
If y'all seen that shit, y'all have to see the last song they performed
in person.
Yes, even on camera, that shit just looked so good. Like, I was like, y'all did that shit.
That was
my favorite song, and then the other one too that I had to ask you to sing. That's my shit when I'm in the shower.
Which one?
Throw it up.
Oh yeah, Hey. Yeah, that song's coming out soon. That's one thing I gotta say. We gotta get our music out, and that's what we're gonna focus on next year, is actually putting this stuff out.
Yeah.
But when I was watching the performance, and like, she was holding the camera, she's lit and camera everywhere. She's singing the lyrics. Yes. So y'all heard her. That was her.
That was very much me.
No, but that's how you know it's real support over here. It's real love.
Yes.
You know, we don't make this shit up. This is real energy, real vibes.
This is my family, y'all.
Yeah, so it goes way
whether
back.
Whether y'all like it or not.
Period. It goes way back to that Atlanta days at Bonfire, bitch.
Oh, my God. We go
back to the time when you brought that girl in her face for me. Like, it's some real love that goes on.
So let's talk about that for a second. So she bopped someone in the face for you?
Yeah. Okay, so it was a situation, right? I awkwardly fell out with this girl for I don't know what reason. I have no idea what happened. I was trying to talk to her at the bonfire where we was at. It was all of us. It was me, you.
Was that same night that happened?
Because
I don't know if y'all realize that scene where I was kissing Jans and they were there. That was a reenactment.
Yeah, that was a reenactment.
That was something that happened.
Years ago.
It could have been four or five years ago. So that was reenactment. So you're saying that same night this happened, right?
That was
a crazy night.
Your birthday. Girl, let's not talk about the birthday.
Okay, yeah.
It was your and birthday.
Her birthday was before all this.
Oh my God. So we had bonfire, whatever, and it was a girl that was there that me and I was cool with that I ended up seeing there, and she was acting funny and whatever. So I was trying to talk to her, whatever, like, but she was egging me on some weird shit. Yeah, so I'm like, what the fuck? Weird. Like, we're I'm like, what happened between us? Like, first of all, I'm trying to reason with you and trying to rekindle whatever it is that's going on. And so it ended up at the end of the night. This whole ended up at my house, okay? And so she came to my house, and the girl apparently knew she was coming to my house, still didn't speak to me, stepped in my door in my house. And I'm like, I know goddamn well this hoe ain't stuck in my house and ain't speaking to me. What the fuck? After I just tried to talk to you at bonfire, you still ain't talking to me and you at my house? Ho, you finna get dragged. Yeah. In my mind, I knew I was finna drag the hoe. But I had to, like, you know, Leo's, we had to process
y'all
shit.
Y'all before,
like,
y'all do shit.
I'm gonna get this hoe, she in my house. Ooh, I'm gonna get this hoe. But before I even thought about the shit, Jordan was already bumped in the dough. Yes. Before the girl even walked in the dough, Jordan ain't even asked no questions. Bop! I was like, oh shit. So that was like, that's when I knew Jordan is like the real deal, like down ass bitch. This my dog for life. Like, that shit was crazy.
Yeah, I don't play. This hoe really tried to ruin the whole night.
Yeah.
And I'm like, we having a good time. It's your birthday. Like, we just had I think, was this day three? Like, what day
was
we
day
on?
Three of my birthday? No, this was around a little bit before COVID happened, because I remember.
So this was like right after your birthday.
Oh,
but
wow.
It was like right after your birthday.
It was like October.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was after my birthday.
Oh, was it? Was it a couple months?
Yeah, it was a couple months, because I remember right after all of that, we got sick. We had all got sick from COVID. I remember I got sick, Jans, King.
I didn't either.
Yeah.
Maybe we're immune to it.
I didn't.
Everybody
a lot of
else
had
did.
Got sick.
So this was like a little bit after your birthday.
Yeah,
so.
It was after my birthday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, that was
so
a lit night.
We had a good time. Birthday came. Jordan was there turning up, like
on the boat.
On the boat.
Oh my God. Bitch, you got that water.
But see, Jans was on the boat too, but she was
she
so
was?
Quiet. Yeah.
She was
on
the
boat.
Yeah. She was chilling.
She was on the boat.
Yeah. Jans was real quiet. She didn't know nobody.
I remember it was like a lot of people that couldn't get on the boat. Bye.
My birthday was so lit. I swear, everybody could not get on the boat. That's how lit it was.
Yeah.
I had to turn people down. Even some of my best
friends. Yeah, her closest friends.
Yeah, there was famous people.
It was famous.
Famous people could not get on the boat.
You couldn't get on the boat.
No, Zane was on the boat though.
No, he wasn't.
He wasn't.
He didn't get on the boat, and I felt so bad
because
the boat was an hour. It was an hour. We're in Atlanta. The boat's an hour away, and there were certain people who couldn't get the boat. I felt bad.
My whole boat ride sucked because I'm like,
hey, I was driving that.
I thought it was lit.
I couldn't get my celebrity friends on this bitch. That's how lit this shit is. I felt so bad. They drove an hour to get to my boat, and they couldn't even get it on.
But it was like they had extra people with them.
Yeah.
And had they been by themselves,
a lot of people had extra people.
A lot of people bought extra people, but I'm like, if I would have known this shit, I would have sent all y'all asses home, like, for real. Because we was going to get a second boat, but my thing is, bitch, if y'all want a second boat, y'all got to put it in.
That's what I'm saying. Because then we put in on the first one.
Yeah.
We sent something.
Exactly. Like, and I'm just like, no, if we're going to do this, y'all finna put in. Everybody else paid. Like, no, we're not doing that.
One thing I'll say is Leia's really good at birthdays.
Yes, you are, girl.
And
you're
she taught
really
me.
Good at organizing and putting shit together.
She's very good. Like, the last birthday she had, I, as y'all saw, I invited a bunch of people. I learned that from her. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You weren't here yet.
I didn't know that you were here.
What month was your birthday?
No, hers,
no, my birthday was in August.
It was probably about
what month?
April. But it was probably around the time you moved here, so I didn't invite you. I didn't know you were here.
Yeah. Were you here? When did you, what month?
I moved here June.
June, July,
so
August.
You were here
for your birthday. I was here.
But I didn't know.
Yeah, you know, we didn't know that.
I don't think nobody was.
I don't think me and you didn't get in contact until like maybe.
Because I set it up, so I invited everybody.
Yeah, I didn't know. It was a surprise birthday.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't know.
Yeah, I invited
everybody. So I haven't seen the pictures. I didn't even see pictures.
There's videos. Yeah.
It was lit. I would have invited you if I would have knew for sure. Without a doubt.
Just like the last time.
I swear. But I'll be here for the next one.
Of course.
Me too.
I know everybody got a lot of questions about like the show, like, okay, who's Jordan? We kind of already covered. I think y'all get the idea that
y'all know
Jordan,
who the fuck I am.
Yeah, Jordan is day one. Honestly, y'all, she ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, okay. Whether you like it or not.
If we get a new bitch tomorrow, Jordan ain't going nowhere. She gonna be the one. If she gotta be messy, she gonna be messy. Cause that's just what she
that's just
getting,
what's gonna happen.
Period. So y'all gotta get used to her being
y'all
a messy.
Y'all want somebody
bitch.
To stir the pot up. That's what I mean. Yeah. They wanting that, but then when it happens,
they
want to be like,
oh, she good.
And then you know what's so crazy? At first they were like, oh, we don't like y'all. Oh, she's sneaky.
Yeah.
But then when you came along, they was like, oh, we don't like Jordan. Oh.
You gotta not. And if it's just me and her, it's like, oh, I don't like Phlo. I don't like Princess.
Oh, yeah.
Or they'd be like, Phlo, he doing too much.
You feel me?
So it's, Phlo play too much.
Look, pick a side.
Exactly.
Pick a side.
People love that. You know what I'm saying? So we do feel like that you brought a lot to the first season, though.
Yeah.
You know, you was there. I felt like there was some things that stirred up, you know what I mean, throughout the season. But I feel like it made sense. You know?
Yeah,
it did.
Like,
make
it made
sense. It all came together.
And a lot of people were commenting and coming after you and trying to bully you. I'm like, look. I mean, at the end of the day, I feel like she's trying to make sure that, you know, if we're going to be around her. Because at the end of the day, I'm sure they saw the episode where we kind of went into the background of all this, all the started. You know what I mean? So let's talk more about that. Like, in Atlanta, obviously, we had something going on at one point in time. But it's been a long time, though.
It has. And it's like, I don't know. For me, when I do some shit like that, it's fun for me. I don't. Yeah. I wasn't in too deep. Apparently, Yon's was like she really loves. She was on something else than I was. For me, it was like a one night. You know, let's turn up. For her, it was like I could see myself really being a part of this, doing this.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. So y'all had different perspectives.
Really,
on
we
things.
Had. Yeah, we both had like different reasons for why.
Right.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah,
so that
I
makes
feel
sense.
That. I think too, what I saw with you was like, and I just know how you are. It's like, I'm going to put some pressure on this bitch. Let me see. Because I already know you were kind of over the situation.
Yeah.
It was more so like, let me test this hoe and see what she
pretty
really
fucking
on.
Fucking much. Yeah.
You know what
that's,
I'm saying?
Like,
if she really cut out for my dogs. Like,
I'm going to put that, I'm going to apply the pressure.
Yeah.
Like, I just wanted to see, like, where you coming from? But she kind of, she tried to step. She tried.
Yeah.
She could have came a little harder and not have you looking like a bully. God damn. Shit. Like, you could have stepped on my neck too.
I think Yance was more so just trying to respect the fact that she knew that you were my people, and she did that, she didn't want to overstep me, because we already had a tension going on, a little tension in between.
Because bitch, you was like, you're not ready.
Man, I was so big on
you. She was mad.
I was so stressed out about this show. And I didn't mean to come off to Yon's that hard.
I was watching after. I was like, man.
Well, that's so funny.
I watched after and I was like, was I really this bad?
Yes.
And
I was like, because you're not ready.
I was like, but I was really stressed out about this show. If y'all look at the show, y'all can understand why. Like, we had to step. It was no option. Like, so I had to apply pressure on her and everybody.
Like, yeah. Do you feel like she performed?
You was on Phlo neck too before you. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Before Jan even got there.
And even you, I was exactly. Like, girl, you got these outfits together.
Right,
like,
right,
up?
Right.
You know what I'm
brushing
saying?
Me,
all that pressure. Yeah. She thinks she a boss or something.
I am.
Oh, and period.
Oh,
and
yeah.
What she said, the princess get
with
the princess
once. Yeah, yeah. Who saying ain't? Who saying opposite? And all
that. I mean, but how do you feel like it came out at the end when you saw the show? How did Jans do?
Okay, so. Oh, you want me to speak on Jans? Okay. Well, I feel like I told you, Leia, like she could have amped it up a little bit more.
No, I'm talking about the show. Like,
yeah, I'm talking about the show.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I feel like her
character. Oh, no, he's talking about the performance.
The performance.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yes. Okay, when it comes to performance, I feel like she did her thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
She really did her thing.
She did.
She did.
She did.
When it comes to the show, though, like the whole show, all like episodes and everything, I could have seen more. Like, she was so monotone to me.
I mean, so
again,
really monotone.
Again, I'm gonna speak on her behalf because yeah. I know that Jans has a lot of respect for me and Phlo. I don't think it was really shy. I think, you know, she was really just trying to understand, like, cause she knows that you're important to us, and
yeah,
she don't want to be
talking
like.
About before I even got there, girl. When I was watching every episode, I was like,
she was doing a lot. You don't think she was doing a lot?
No,
oh,
I don't.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't.
Going into the show,
it made me look like when I got there, I was really doing.
No,
something.
They was dragging her before that though.
Really?
They
I
was.
Didn't even check. Sneaky.
No, that.
But I was like, damn, like this making me look like
no.
I came on here and made this show look.
No,
hip-hop.
No. Because they was like, oh, she messy. She sneaky. She trying to sneak in.
I
the
did
shower.
See some kind of like that.
Oh,
but
she
sneaky.
Wants Phlo more
yeah,
than
she wants more.
And I'm like, and it's
a lot of people say that.
I know better. Yeah. Know better, so I was like, I'm not seeing it the way everybody else sees.
So how do you see it?
Okay,
I see it like shit. She was super shy, first of all, okay. Or maybe just not camera. I don't know, but to me, it was coming off like nervous. Like,
but she
was nervous to be there.
I get that.
Or maybe you was intimidating her. I don't know. But it was giving nervous.
Well, it's different when you put cameras in the room. You know,
yeah.
I feel like a lot of things happen. You know, differently because we had cameras in the room. And that's why I'm like, even with them going into the shower, I'm like, you would never do this for real. Because the camera here, y'all want to fucking play with me. That's what it really is.
Yeah.
But it's a lot of stuff that transpires when the cameras are in the room. You know, this is reality. When you step into reality TV, it's a whole different vibe. But what I can say about Jans is she never really switched up. Like, even when we,
that's true.
When the episodes was coming out, I was in Atlanta with her. We was like laughing together, like, bitch, they seeing this? Oh my God.
Right.
They don't even know what's really going on between
right.
us. They don't know. So we actually
because
laugh about
just
it.
To point out, like, we'll shoot a show. And it'll be, and, you know, we shot it, but we might not get it back till what, a couple weeks later?
Yeah, a couple weeks
so
later.
So it's
yeah.
not necessarily in real time.
Yeah.
So there's drama going on, but in all reality.
We good.
Yeah, pretty
yeah,
good.
Yeah, yeah. And so even with Jordan, like, y'all would look at it like, oh, Jordan is this, and she didn't like Jans, but really, they squashed the beef.
It.
And she recorded it.
If y'all watching the live, the live, like.
Oh, the live!
At the
crib.
Hold
up,
wait.
Live.
We didn't even get to the live. We didn't get to the live.
Jordan and Jans was getting on my fucking nerves.
No, but for real, we trying to give y'all what y'all want.
Yeah, yeah, okay. That part. And you know, like I said,
I feel like the show went amazing. I feel like we all, as far as the performance went amazing. And we gotta do some more shows. We gotta do some more performances.
We gotta release some more music.
Yeah, so
y'all need to hit the road or something.
But if I hit the road, you're coming with me.
Yes, period. Let me know because I have to take off my.
But okay, so like, so how are you now? Where are you at in life now? Like, what's going on?
I'm still, you know, I'm still in Houston. I'm still working, doing my thing. Hopefully, y'all will see me. Actually, y'all will see me on season 2.
Yes.
So if y'all want to see me anywhere, so far they want me to audition for all these other shows.
Yeah.
You know,
do
like,
it.
Do
take
it.
Take your opportunities. Yes.
Yeah.
I kind of like where I am here. I found home on being the show. Cause I feel like if I go on any other show, y'all gonna really see some real ratchet shit. I can keep it as ratchet as I want here.
Yeah,
yeah.
You can monitor it.
Yeah, I don't have to take it far. Like they want me to do. They want to see me on some baddies and all that ratchet stuff.
And I feel like that's fit for you.
It is,
but
I like it here. Cause it's like I ain't gotta push it.
Right.
It's just a little pressure.
Yeah, it's a little pressure, but I ain't gotta. damn near sacrificing myself to go to jail.
Yeah, I feel that. Because I did audition for Baddies, and after I did that, and I realized, I was like,
"This not for you.
That's not for me. Exactly. I'm not doing it. I don't like it. They rejected me, and it's okay, baby. Because guess what? I don't need Baddies.
You bigger than that.
I got my own show.
Exactly. You got your own fucking show.
Okay. And then not only one show, bitch. I got two shows.
Period. Yeah.
No, listen.
You got three. You got three shows.
What's the other one?
Oh,
you
got one on your channel. And I have my own channel.
Stop playing with me.
Tree shows, ho.
Stop playing with me. Period.
So, I mean, I feel like it was a good experience to go in audition, though. Yeah. Just to kind of see what it was and realize maybe this isn't for you. And I supported it, you know. Yeah, I don't know how many dudes were like, oh, you want to be on Baddies?
Broke up with their girl.
You feel me?
Take your home.
But I actually paid for her trip to go.
Yeah,
I paid for her whole trip because, hey, look, there's a lot of dudes out there who are like, I don't want my girl to be more successful than me. I don't want my girl to have more followers than me. A lot of dudes are like that.
Yeah, they are.
I'm just keeping it a G. But I'm personally like, hey, look, I want you to be successful. If you get more success than me,
we both got the success.
Then we're both, you know what I'm saying? I mean, we're both going to be paid, you know what I mean,
exactly,
at the end of the day.
Okay, we
went
in together.
Exactly.
Yeah, talk about that a little bit more. Because I have been in situations with guys like that was not, they would not let me be on the show. Furthermore, let pull up with me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, shout out to him.
Exactly. Shout out to him right now. Shout out to Bae. He in his own little world. But
she said.
Yeah, but I dated a lot of guys that was not feeling that. Like, oh, you want to be on TV? Oh, who you trying to show off for? Like, it's secure as hell. But I love that for you guys. Because y'all support each other and uplift each other. Y'all are a great example of a couple.
Aww.
On and off camera.
We appreciate that.
Yes.
I love to hear stuff like that. So what can we expect next? Because, you know, we got season two coming up.
Yes.
So
if you're ready for season two, comment below. Season two of TRI LUV.
Yeah.
Coming soon.
Ooh.
Coming soon.
Boy, the new
it's going
to
be crazy. It's going to be crazy in season one.
Yeah, it will.
It's gonna be
crazy.
I
can see that. We need to take a trip or something.
That's what I'm
saying. If we go out of town, it's gonna get real, real sticky.
We gotta take a trip.
It's gonna be really sticky. At least Atlanta. If we don't go north,
that's where we going.
We going
Atlanta.
I don't
know about my mind, but when you say Atlanta,
Atlanta, or Miami.
That's where it all started. Atlanta is where it all started. So we gotta go back to Atlanta. It only makes sense.
Right.
Yeah.
So.
We're not going to tell y'all too much about what's coming soon.
We're going to talk.
Stay tuned.
Right. But thank you, Jordan.
No, thank y'all for having me. Oh, I miss y'all so much. I ain't see y'all in the
Girl, place. We live right up the street from each other.
Jordan, I was really going to see you tomorrow.
Look, I do Jordan's hair, her mom's hair, so like,
I see her a lot.
And then plus, it's family.
We are family.
Yeah, for sure.
So anything y'all going to see on my page, I'm going to be supporting Leia. I'm going to be supporting Phlo. Like, this is my family right here.
Yeah, for sure.
But we really appreciate it. We appreciate you guys
for having me once
again. Yes.
Let's take another shot.
No, she ready.
Ooh, that's what I'm talking about.
All right, let's do it.
She's taking a shot in and out.
Period. Let's close it off on a good note.
Yes. Okay, let's do it. I'm gonna do like that. Cause last time, there you go. Ooh. I almost dropped mine.
Don't do that again. You trying to have no
repeat of that episode. Not another mess on the floors of Mad Studio. You saw that last episode.
No. The performance, right?
No.
No, she's talking about the Luv Xperience.
The Luv Xperience.
Yeah.
Yeah, they be getting confused between the two.
Yeah, because I feel like y'all need a playlist. Why don't y'all have a playlist?
We do.
I think we do. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we do. Okay. And then also the colors. Like, if you ever see a colorful black background, that's the Luv Xperience.
Mm.
But if you see like just a regular picture of somebody or whatever that's normal, you'll see
that's
TRI LUV. But it'll say it on there. We'll always
put it
on there.
Yeah, we see the name, but I'll be looking at the pictures, girl.
I think it's confusing because they both have
Luv in them.
Yeah. Yes,
so just so y'all know, we got TRI LUV, which is like a poly, you know, show about our poly relationship.
Trying to make that poly relationship work.
You feel me? And then we have the Luv
Xperience. When we cheers into
season two.
Season two.
Let's get it.
All right, y'all. I'm gonna go
suck
my man dick.
Oh,
okay. I'll see y'all later.
That's tea.
That's real tea.
Go do your thing, girl. Yes, ma'am. Okay.
All right, we'll see y'all in the next episode.